sunshine in the belly of the beach, but outside there's a war going on your front lawn. Black Hawk, see the red dawn horizon. Blind yet I'm rising, abiding by laws of attraction. My thoughts still rising, thinking. What type of knowledge gon' sink in? Life gives you limits and my only thought is drinking. Thirsty, will I be alive or dead before 30? That's all that concerns me early. Lemonade quenching my inner rage when it takes center stage. Way before they pouring on my grave. Minute made, let it set my soul ablaze. On each and every wave, put me in the water for the save.
They don't know my name.
Listen to everything around me, I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee rolling thunder. Don't hear my cry, don't let alibis pass you by. Finally starting to realize, never give up and coincide. Can't watch TV, it's all a lot. Tired of trying, go ahead and fly. Everybody want a straight answer, but media keep us blind. A good heart is not hard to find. Why do people try to define infrastructure? I don't got time, infrastructure, I don't got time. I could it's all too. We're talking about your brother protecting themselves and daughters from political mislaughter.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Never play by the rules, guess I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude, poison the multitude. They be quick to accuse, when you got different views. Just know you gon' pay the price, based off the item you choose. Many ties in the culture, hit you with MK Ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't trust you, shock you, deny you, fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered, doing this so subtle. Falling out through the rubble, remember this in jungle. The top, I was gonna get something, the middle, gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing, why the rush up for nothing. Why the rush up for nothing, why the rush up for nothing. Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. The institution, modern day execution. Think I know the solution, maybe not should I do it. Just put it in the music, just put it in the music.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave. You're burning out.
First opened in 2002, there's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Green Bay Packers and the Detroit Lions. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
23-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He's going to get that to Swift underneath. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Meanwhile, the throw here is complete, and they'll take him down at the 31-yard line.
It's a gain of four. Makes it third and two.
An early test. Two plays in. This is third and two. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. An early test. Two plays in. This is third and two. First down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 11 yards there and a Lion first down. They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
Out to the left, flat and complete. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Second and 12. This one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Third down, now even tougher. Third and 13 after that loss of a yard. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Now he'll let it go deep left side. And that will be incomplete. Scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback.
20-yard line.
And the Packers now with a first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. And he'll go down at the 26 following a gain of 6.
Tracy Walker.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
26-yard line.
From the 26, they'll line up on second and 4. Now a handoff here to his running back. That result really no surprise. That's what we're coming accustomed to with this number one ranked rush defense.
And you study the game. Does this bring back a few memories? Maybe the 85 Bears trying to move the ball against them, 2000 Ravens. Heck, how about the late 60s, early 70s purple people eaters, the Minnesota Vikings? Hard to move the ball against those types of teams.
This time with Love. Eluding the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. Give him 7 on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
First down there, but it's incomplete. Rico Gafford, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tuck rule that they can fall back on anymore.
And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
third down. Love airing it out for Hamilton. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Packers.
Caught by number 10.
A big play there with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Packers have taken the early lead.
The kick,
and it's good to make it 7-0 Packers.
Makes the score, Packers 7, Lions nothing.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Back to throw. That's complete to DeAndre Swift out of the backfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They'll get a dozen there, and the Lions have a first down.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody covered. Oh, he just stuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. A play action fake. They'll look to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Incomplete.
The pass thrown away and incomplete. Brings up a third down and 10 yards to go.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. He'll find Swift out of the backfield. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 11 yards there and a Lion first down. That time, that was get ball, throw ball.
Yeah, turn into a smoke route. If you see the coverage off the receiver, doesn't matter whether you call it a run or not. Just take the ball, get it out to it.
On first and 10, it's Swift. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
At the 25 yard line.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Packers 7, Lions nothing.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Open man, he's got him, the tight end, Hockenson. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. First time they've hooked up here. Good for 17 and a first down.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
Here's Swift. And the Lions are going to be set up with a first and goal as good running gets him down to about the 4-yard line. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yeah, it's now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
One more time with Swift. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. DeAndre Swift, his 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2.
Ties the game at 7. Matt Prater to kick off for Detroit.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
First down, going to the air with Love. Airing it out for Hamilton. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked by Tracy Walker, and he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Well, if you go by the numbers, you'll find as the temperature goes down, so does the passing efficiency. And now that we're in December, even the routine throws are going to be harder for the quarterbacks. And this one, it winds up getting picked off.
There, it'll be second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
They stay on the ground. This time it's Johnson, and he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about 4.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
The Lions on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. They'll try and run here with Swift. And he's going to get to the 31. Enough for the first down. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and it'll move the chains.
So it's pretty simple, partner. You pick up a turnover, set you up in excellent field position. The last thing you want to do is go 3 and out in this spot.
Yeah, they would have had to settle for a field goal attempt, but now they keep those touchdown hopes alive. And this is taken in at the 5. 27-yard pickup. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
No gain there on the completion. It'll be 2nd down.
And goal at the 4-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, 2nd and goal. They'll run here with Swift, and he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line.
Darnell Savage.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get a second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier, was bidding for a second. Through a couple of plays, this Green Bay defense is held strong. Now it's third and goal. Toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2 yard line. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. A field goal would break the tie, but look at this. Instead, they're going to go for it on fourth and goal. Now a shotgun snap as they look to throw. And it is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. DeAndre Swift with touchdown number 15 on the year and second of the game. And the Lions have taken the lead. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. Ready to get their next drive underway. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. To pass, here's Jordan Love. And it's going to be caught. It's Rico Gafford. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. With Evans, and down he goes at the 49, a 3 yard pickup.
The ball carrier.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3 yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Now a throw out to his fullback is complete, and down he goes at the 49, a 3 yard pickup. Once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And he is going to have a Packers first down. He needed five. He got it barely, as it will officially go down as a gain of 5 yards.
So Packer first down.
They'll run on first down with Evans. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Out on the edge, you love to have cornerbacks like that that can bring them down to the run game.
And you're also exposed to everyone. It really becomes a one-on-one play, doesn't it? You're out there by yourself on the edge. The best ones know how to make the play, and we just saw an example of it right there.
Airing it out for Hamilton. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, Packers.
Touchdown.
A big play there with his 14th touchdown of the year, second of the game. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. That extra point splits the uprights. And we've got a tie game here in a back-and-forth first half. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
At their own 17-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And we're under a minute to go here in what's been an even first half, all tied up.
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. A couple completions just bring them together. Could get into field goal range. Let's see what happens.
And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down. They run out of the gun with Swift. And they'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
That's the kind of run that gets everyone excited on offense. And, you know, oftentimes the guys who carry the ball are the ones in the huddle doing the chirping. Right now I think it's the offensive line telling them, run it again. We are right there about to break a big one.
One more time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he's going to have a first down, but not sure it'll matter as the clock will continue to run. The Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. So first and 10 now from the 30. The gun. They'll look to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. DeAndre Swift, the intended receiver that time. And now it's second down.
At the 30-yard line.
Flush to his right. And that is incomplete here.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And incomplete. Clock down now to 13 seconds. Here's Jack Fox now as he'll kick it away for the second time. 46 on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. This is fielded at the 7. So a 56-yard punt, they'll net 31 after the 15-yard return. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
So we've hit halftime all even at 14 apiece. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, and ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard.
It's over! It's over! Let's dominate!
Now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll begin on the ground with Evans. That one good for 10 yards, and it'll be second and very short.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. And they'll go right back to Evans, looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a third and one.
No gain on the play, and it brings up third down.
On third and one, Love to throw. And he finds Hamilton. That's complete. And he is going to have a Packers first down, and comfortably so, as he gets five there on third and a yard. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. Secured by his running back out of the backfield. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 37-yard line. They run the counter. It's Evans. And he'll slice his way down to the 30 with a pickup of 7.
The ball carrier.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. They'll go again here with Evans. About 3 yards there to the 27.
Darrington.
A big part of a middle linebacker's job is being able to take on blocks and then go make plays. But the best ones, they have those big guys in front of them playing defensive line that hold blockers off of them and allow them to flow sideline to sideline and make the big hits.
Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's third and inches. They'll try and run for this with Evans. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. Give him the third down conversion. 5 yards on the play.
A gain of 5. And a Packer first down.
Now they'll run it on the toes. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. That's their first time getting to the quarterback, sack number one. And, you know, they had 5 last week, I'm remembering.
And you have to find a way to slow down the pass rush, not necessarily with just protecting your quarterback, but you show them a lot of different looks, and they did that in the first half. You know, different angles, different things to slow down the speed. They got to him here in the second half. Now they got to come over the counter to that and maybe do something different.
And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. They'll get 6 there on the run, but it brings up 4th down.
Brings up 4th down.
His kick is good, and the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. They don't get a touchdown here on the opening drive of the third quarter, but I think maybe you still say mission accomplished as they come away with the lead.
No, absolutely. You keep the pressure on, right? You go downfield, get some points up on the board, and hope that you motivated your defense to take the field and hold that lead.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Offense ready to kick off their next drive. And here we are almost through 3 quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Now it's Swift. Pushing forward for 3 up to the 48.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. On play action, they'll throw. That's complete to Swift out of the backfield. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
So into Packer territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 34. Completion, 2nd and 10. Well, he caught it right at the line of scrimmage, and before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch, and most offenses make a living off of yards after catch. Those hidden yards that may not go into the score sheet, but they count big for moving the ball and stretching the field. Really nice open field tackle.
On 2nd down, Swift. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
He's brought down at the 31. That's a gain of 3. It's 3rd and 7.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this 3rd down play as we play 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Get this to the 24 on 3rd down. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. DeAndre Swift, 31 yards. And the Lions are going to jump back in front. He's got the hat trick, three touchdowns now.
Did you throw yours? Did you throw yours?
I didn't have mine. You've got yours. You've got one of those Abe Lincoln hats.
Yeah, and that stovepipe is going right out there for a nose for the end zone. Third time today. I think he deserves a tip of the cap.
Fielded in the end zone.
The Packers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. Space to maneuver at the 40. And finally marked down at the 42-yard line. That one good for 33 and a first.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
First down, love to pass. He's going to rifle one deep left side. Touchdown, Packers. Rico Gafford with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Packers have retaken the lead. Might be seeing that one on the highlight shows tonight. The home run ball here in the fourth quarter to take the lead.
There's nothing like being aggressive, preaching that to your team, and then following through. All the way through. Go ahead and throw one more up there. Why not?
Been a great game, and we are not done yet. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Ready to begin their drive. And they had the touchdown during the last drive, and I'm guessing that you like the balance they had on that last drive.
And I loved it. Forget liking it. Absolutely love what they were doing, because to be ahead of the defense that much, where every play call you have, run or pass, is working pretty well for you.
Makes you look like a genius.
It really does. It also lets you know that your preparation was pretty good, and now the defense has to do all the adjusting.
Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Now a play fake here on first down. Catch is made by Hawkinson, the tight end. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Dave's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. From the gun, here's Swift. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
The Lions on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Once again, it's Swift. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. That'll set them back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that's going to bring up a 4th down. And here now the punter, Fox, as he sends this one away. And they will get to this one and down it at the 13-yard line.
At their own 13-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
Love now to pass on first down. That's into the hands of Gafford, complete. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Love now on second down. And he finds the tight end, Reed. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
First down.
Love. This one complete to Gafford. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
On second down, it's Evans. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 11 yards there, first down. And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
That one looks like he'll throw here. Down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 28. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as it comes with a minute 25 left to go in the contest. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Play fake. Here's Love. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And this would have been intercepted if he could have gotten the feet in. Instead, it's incomplete. Boy, that really could have turned this one upside down. So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down.
And it's third down.
Play Now Love. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs, able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
Nope, never had a chance. Well to the right, no good. And this score will stay right where it is. Maybe an important fourth quarter miss as this stays a three-point game.
Yeah, now overtime is very much in the equation here. Just what you mentioned, a three-point game, they get a drive, put it through the post. We could have some free football, couldn't we?
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
Practice makes perfect. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Running from the gun, Johnson. And he gets this only to the 41, not near enough for the first. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They'll look to throw. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Trey Flowers make that now 8 sacks for him on the season. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Rico Gafford, the intended target, but now it'll be third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Love. One that's intercepted. Picked off by Daylon Buchanan. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
Intercepted. The Lions take over.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Well, this is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you go to the film, find out where the game was really lost. This is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here. Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. One final shot. They'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle.